Hey, it's Alex, back to talk to you about troubleshooting item group issues in Shopping Actions. If you don't know how to set up item groups yet, click the info card in the upper right corner of the screen to watch that video first. Item group issues can be bucketed into three categories: item group duplicates, item group inconsistencies, and item group missing information. In this video, you'll learn how to identify and troubleshoot item group duplicate issues that may be blocking your assortment from being sold through Shopping Actions. So, what does an item group issue look like? Well, I'm selling two Google t-shirts. They're the same size, but have different colors. I know they're different, but I forgot to give the shirts a color in my feed. Without these colors, Google is not able to tell the difference between the two and thinks that they're duplicates. But that can be quickly fixed by adding a color value to these offers. In Merchant Center, duplicate errors can show up as duplicate variant or duplicate product. The diagnostics page in Merchant Center can be very helpful to troubleshoot these issues. Now, let me show you how to fix this item group issue through Merchant Center. In Merchant Center, click on Products, and then Diagnostics. Change the destination filter to Shopping Actions. Scrolling down, you can see that one of our errors is duplicate variant. You can click View Samples, or you can download a report of all offers that have this error. Now, let's click View Samples, and then let's click on the first offer. This will bring up the Merchant Center product page and contain all the information you submitted for this offer. Scrolling down, let's find the item group ID for this offer. We can see that this offer has an item group ID of Google T-shirt duplicates. Now, let's head over to our feed in Google Sheets. After sorting and filtering by our item group ID, there are two offers in this group. They are small Google T-shirts with different colors based on their titles. However, the only variant attribute that we're using is size. Here's a tip. If you're going to use item groups, make sure that each offer has at least one attribute that makes it unique from the rest. Now, let's update our offers with a color value. We have a green shirt and a blue shirt. Now that we've added our colors, let's go back to Merchant Center. Click Fetch Now to upload the changes. Changes may take a few hours to appear in Merchant Center for you to review. As a reminder, you can choose from a large set of variants for your item groups. Some common variant attributes are color, format, material, and size. If your variant offers differ based on something our variant attributes do not cover, then you can use the product details attribute. This attribute allows you to create custom variant attributes to differentiate your products. And that's it. Now that I've shown you how to fix my item group issue, go into Merchant Center and see if you can troubleshoot your own item group issues. Check out our next video to learn how to troubleshoot inconsistent and missing item group issues. The Help Center article is included in the links below. Thanks for watching!